Hello, you are viewing this video because you are scheduled for carpal tunnel release. I'm sure you have many questions about your procedure. I'm going to discuss the anatomy and diagnosis of carpal tunnel syndrome. I will also describe the procedure and the associated risks. I will detail the postoperative care and course. I hope this video will answer most, if not all, of your questions. Should you have more questions, I'll be happy to answer them at your next follow-up visit. Please follow along in the presentation booklet we've provided. Let's get started. On the hand, the muscles on either side of the palm nearly come together near the wrist. The space in between the muscles in the center is the carpal tunnel. The tunnel is made of a U-shaped bony bottom with a thick band of tissue forming a roof. The carpal tunnel starts on the end of the forearm and extends to the mid-palm. The median nerve provides sensation to the thumb, index, middle, and half of the ring fingers. A branch of the median nerve called the motor branch also feeds the thumb muscles. The median nerve and flexor tendons enter the hand inside the tunnel. Carpal tunnel syndrome is compression of the nerve inside the tunnel. Usually there is no identifiable reason for the compression. Occasionally the flexor tendons will swell and compress the nerve, or possibly a cyst will form inside the carpal tunnel. The diagnosis is made by clinical findings and nerve testing. Clinically, carpal tunnel causes numbness and tingling in the thumb, index, middle, and half of the ring fingers. Sometimes there will also be related pain in the wrist and forearm. Symptoms are worse with repetitive activities of the hand, sleeping, and certain grasping activities. Patients commonly complain of dropping things because they are unable to gauge grip strength and or are weak. A Tinel's test is reproduction of a shooting tingling into the median nerve distribution with tapping in the wrist. A Phalen's test is prolonged wrist flexion, which also reproduces symptoms in the median nerve distribution. Electromyogram and nerve conduction velocity tests, known as EMGs and nerve conduction velocities, are necessary for proper diagnosis. They discriminate a carpal tunnel syndrome from other nerve problems, which will not be helped via carpal tunnel release. The indication for surgical treatment is lack of response to rest and carpal tunnel splinting, along with a positive EMG and nerve conduction test. The surgery I perform is an open carpal tunnel release. This involves a small incision on the palm of the hand and complete release of the transverse carpal ligament to decompress the nerve. The procedure is outpatient and takes approximately 20 minutes and requires only light anesthesia. Complications of open carpal tunnel release are rare, but include wound problems, transection of the nerve and or tendons, continued carpal tunnel symptoms, and stiffness of the fingers, thumb, and wrist. Early motion is very important to avoid post-op stiffness. Patients with long-term compression who are older than 65 in general will have less improvement after carpal tunnel release. You will be placed into a fiberglass post-op splint in the operating room. Keep this on until your first follow-up. Bring a carpal tunnel splint to your first follow-up. You will be placed into it after the post-op splint is removed for your wound check. Sutures are generally removed at 7 days, but may need to stay in longer. Your follow-up appointments are at 7 days, 6 weeks, and 12 weeks. Initiate finger and thumb motion as soon as possible after surgery to avoid stiffness and decrease swelling. Elevation of the hand is helpful. Ice can be applied, but its effect is limited by the fiberglass splint. After your first follow-up, remove the carpal tunnel splint at least several times a day for thumb, finger, and wrist motion. However, wear the splint when using the hand for any activity. Avoid direct pressure onto the palm for 6 weeks after surgery. When your sutures are removed, it is okay to get your incision wet. Prior to this, keep your incision clean and dry. If you're having difficulty moving the fingers or wrist in the first 2 weeks, contact the office. therapy may be needed. Pain after surgery should be minimal and last for about 3 to 5 days. Preoperative pain is relieved quickly after surgery. The numbness and tingling should be improved by the first follow-up. Maximum benefit can take up to a year, but the majority of your relief should be present by 3 months. Carpal tunnel surgery is very safe and successful. Making the diagnosis is the key to success, and an EMG and nerve conduction study is a necessary test to confirm the diagnosis. Avoiding pressure on the incision after surgery is very important. Early motion of the fingers, thumb, and wrist will help avoid stiffness. Please follow the post-op instructions, and you put yourself in the best position to relieve the carpal tunnel symptoms and improve your hand function. This will help allow you to return to the activities that you love.